Bogdanovich. Yeah, no. God damn it, that's the jazz one.
Okay, finally. Thank you, Steve. Jesus Christ.
Bogdanovich is a dynamic player, but he mainly serves only one purpose, as a shooter for the Sacramento Kings. As one of the most talented free agents this summer, Bogdanovich's game deserves a thorough examination. While in Sacramento, Bogdanovich has mainly been used as a three-point threat due to their best offense being some variation of high pick and roll with a four-out offensive scheme to keep four shooting threats behind the three-point line so the team's star, De'Aaron Fox, can work inside the paint. That role as an outside shooter is often the core skill attributed to Bogdanovich, despite only making 36% of his threes this season. That 36% could be way higher, but he's being asked to do too much. Bogdanovich now takes 7 threes a game, more than specialists like Joe Harris or JJ Redick, which means more off the dribble threes or shots from beyond 25 feet. His 6'6 frame, 6'11 wingspan, and perfect mechanics, even in cramped space, means that there is little that any opposing point or two guard can do to bother his shot if he has his feet set. But this season, he quite frequently took unneeded bad shots. What would his percentage look like without all the off-the-dribble attempts? Here is where he ranks up against the best catch-and-shoot players in the league. You can see that he is just a tick below the elite off-ball shooters. So he is still an absurdly great shooter, but on the Kings, he is often treated more like a Steph Curry than a JJ Redick light. Although he's a dominant off-ball shooter, the severe lack of threats from deep on the Kings roster forced Bogdanovich to shoot almost every time he touched the ball. Most key role players for Sacramento were horrendous from deep this year. Marvin Bagley, Anthony Tolliver, and Dwayne Dedmon all shot less than 20%. Yogi Ferrell shot only 27%, and De'Aaron Fox regressed from last year and barely shot above 30%. That lack of spacing also limited Bogdanovich from doing what he seems to enjoy the most. Being a point guard. Bogdanovich is a different player than the impetuous De'Aaron Fox or Buddy Hield. He loves to survey the half court like Terminator, scanning for any weaknesses in the defense before making his move. When the defense doubles or stunts towards Bogey on a pick and roll, he'll typically hit the roll man with this over-the-top early pass for an easy one-dribble flush or open three, making Bogdanovich the best pick and roll guard on the Kings due to his shooting threat if the defense closes on the roll man. Or, if both defenders get too close to Bogdanovich, he always has his pass up his sleeve. He can obviously throw a basic driving kick to someone who is probably about to miss a wide open three, and when he gets to the rim, he can serve up a fresh dime in the tiniest window. You'll notice that he loves these one-arm whip passes that he can get off with either hand and generates a lot of layups or open threes, but this type of pass can be ineffective when the correct play is a lob. He's completely capable of throwing the lob, but he won't sometimes despite the option being there. He'll typically always go with the safer option, not challenging himself to make passes through tighter angles, even though he clearly has the ability. His assist numbers are very low for someone who has the capability to be the point guard of a team. He averaged 5 assists per 36 last year, and it seemed like he was growing more comfortable and would continue to increase that assist rate year after year, but it stagnated this season as the team brought on another point guard and gave Hield and Barnes a much longer leash on ball. Watch him on this clip. First, he tells Holmes where to set up, then directs Hield where to go for an easy three. He has the mindset of a floor general, but is severely limited by poorly designed plays, his own tendency to stay back, and a lack of on-ball skills. In the half court, he mainly uses body positioning and understanding the defense in order to get to the paint. While being able to use those skills to your advantage proves his high basketball IQ, you can't be a lead guard on a good team if you can't consistently create opportunities out of nothing. It's not that he's lazy, but his lack of athleticism and dribble skills making attacking with a set defense a laborious ordeal for Bogdanovich. Watch him struggle to get even a hint of space on an easy defensive assignment in Kyle Kuzma. A great creator can disrupt entire imposing defenses as they scramble to cover the holes that the opposing guard just created. Bogdanovich can't break down defenses like that. He turns the ball over less than twice per game with a 1.8 assist to turnover ratio, so it's not that he's sloppy with the ball, he just can rarely put together a string of moves to beat his defender off the dribble. He is much better offensively cutting off the ball than with the ball in his hands. His struggles to dismantle the defense with the ball in his hands is his biggest weakness and biggest restrictor to him being the main force in an offense. Sometimes it feels like you're watching that guy at the park who does a million crossovers that go nowhere until he gets blocked at the rim. Although, he's actually incredibly efficient beneath the three-point line, in particular at the rim, where he shot 65.8% this season, higher than his rim-wrecking backcourt mate De'Aaron Fox and other famous slashing guards like MVP season Derrick Rose or Finals MVP Tony Parker. It doesn't matter who is at the rim, Bogdanović can finish with his left, his right, with teammates falling on him, or even when he throws his wacky-looking floater. He's also elite from between 16 feet and the three-point line, those long twos, where he shot 58%, higher than any Ray Allen or Kevin Durant season. Bogdanović is surprisingly excellent in almost every offensive scenario as well. For reference, I'll compare him to players who have a similar amount of possessions in each opportunity per game. In isolation, he scores 1 point per possession, more than Ben Simmons, Bam Adebayo, Jaylen Brown, or Kevin Love. As a spot-up shooter, he scores 1.6 points per possession, more than Jason Tatum, Fred VanVleet, Kristaps Porzingis, or Devin Booker. As a ball handler out of pick and roll, he scores 0.89 points per possession, more than Blake Griffin, Jaylen Brown, Ben Simmons, or Gordon Hayward. And in transition, he scores 1.17 points per possession, more than Damian Lillard, Karl-Anthony Towns, or Jamal Murray. He's in the 63rd percentile or higher for all those scoring opportunities. Put him at any spot on the floor or in any scoring scenario, and the defense is pretty much always at a disadvantage. His multiple game-winning shots prove that he is someone the defense can never leave unguarded at the end of games, because he's not afraid to shoot and not afraid to miss, and as Michael Jordan always said,
Bugs Bunny.
You were expecting maybe the Easter Bunny?
You're a cartoon, you're not real.
Jim, you used the right clip, right? You didn't use the Space Jam one? Alright, thanks dude. Okay, where were we? Anyway, the reason these numbers may sound surprisingly high is because he is so quick to disappear. The Serbian guard has had the same amount of games with 20 to 29 points as games with 1 to 9, with only one game above 30 for the entire season. His lack of on-ball skills and ability to get free from an opponent quickly is the biggest factor, but so is the Kings' current offensive scheme that does not take advantage of Bogdanović's catch-and-shoot skills or off-ball cutting wizardry. Probably the least talked about aspect of Bogdanović's game is his defense. I don't know why he doesn't get any respect on the defensive end. I keep asking my girlfriend and she keeps yelling at me to stop bringing up his defense every time I see her, but let's talk about it. His overall team defense can struggle because he can get lost on hard screens, resulting in a few open threes, and he does not like to stay close to his assignment off ball. But he is an excellent one-on-one defender due to his positioning, chest out, not afraid to get as close as possible, arms up. Watch him stop Brandon Clark, then cut off Ja Morant, which forces a turnover. His 6'11 wingspan makes him a valuable multi-positional defender. He also has very quick hands, which can result in these absurd-looking strips. He's averaged almost 2 steals per 100 possessions this season. But the best part about Bogdanović's defense is his effort, especially on the apathetic Kings. When the rest of the team is jogging to cover their defenders on a fast break, Bogdanović will sprint around trying to cover any holes. He especially loves getting into this early charge position, so the offense has to quickly adjust at the rim, but he for some reason never actually gets on time to draw charges. Only a really good offense can throw Bogdanović off his game. If you set weak picks against him, he'll slither by, making himself smaller, and if you try just ISO against him thinking he can't keep up, you're about to be surprised. Bogdanović has a lot more talent than he has shown over the past 3 years, but at age 28, at the start of next season, is it worth throwing him a contract? Yes. Well, yes, yes. It should be an easy yes for every team. Even if he doesn't develop into a great ball handler and the fringe all-star to all-star I believe he could be, he's already a great passer, a major threat from deep, and a good defender who would start or be the best six-man option for every team. Most 3-and-D options are a major risk when putting the ball on the floor, but Bogdanović can play the role of a lead guard with the ball in his hands, then switch to a deadly 2-guard when running around off-ball. If he can improve as a point of attack guard and start looking to dominate in ways that he often tried away from in the past, he can quickly rise up to all-star or fringe all-star status. But that's what I think. What about you? If you liked this video, or even if you didn't, please like and subscribe, and follow me on Twitter to talk more hoops.